Hello, welcome to the first video in the tutorial series for OrCAD X Presto, where we'll take a completed OrCAD X schematic and do a start to finish PCB layout in the new Presto tool. My name is Adam Fuchs. I'm a product engineer at Cadence Design Systems, and I'll be your guide for this set of tutorials. Now, this is meant to be more of a casual series of videos rather than formal ones. Each video will also have a layout database that you can download in case you want to follow along, or if you get lost somewhere along the way. Just as a quick disclaimer, we generally won't be covering PCB design techniques or electronic concepts in these videos. Rather, it's meant to help familiarize new users with the Presto user interface, different commands that you have access to, and just the general design flow. I might sometimes make mention of some PCB layout concepts, but generally they'll only be used to reference to certain Presto functions or commands and why they work that the way they do. By the end of the series, you will have completed a full layout. I have one open here. It is actually what we're going to be making from start to finish. Once we've completed it, we will also have all the files and information necessary to create manufacturing files for a PCB board. Now, while the design isn't too complex, completing it does cover most, if not all, of the basics in using the tool. Let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to go ahead and close this Presto window. And here we are in OrCAD X. So in the first video, we're going to cover the basics of setting up your design so that we can netlist into Presto. We're also going to make sure that you can push changes back and forth with updates. So for example, if you need to make last minute wiring changes, change a reference designator, etc. And then of course, we need to make sure that we can also crossfire between the schematic and the layout. Now on my screen here, I have an OrCAD X capture design open. I've added parts to three different pages. There's the power page, the micro page, and the peripherals page. It's a basic schematic with a microcontroller and some peripherals. The first thing we need to do is make sure that we can netlist the schematic into Presto. So to do so, we go up into this PCB menu at the top here and select Design Sync Setup. What we're looking for is this Select Layout tool. Now by default, this should be set to PCB Editor. But by selecting the drop-down here, go ahead and select OrCAD X Presto. This just makes it so that when we netlist or start a new layout, the OrCAD X capture design will automatically open that design in OrCAD X Presto. You can leave the rest of these as their default and then press OK. Now we're ready to netlist the design. And to do that, same thing, we go to the PCB menu at the top and select new layout. From here, go ahead and change the PCB layout folder if you need to. I would suggest leaving it as default. It's just a subfolder within your OrCAD's project directory. Since this is a brand new design, just leave the input board file empty. And then for the board, go ahead and set a name. I'm going to keep it as howto.brd. Go ahead and hit OK. Now, if there's any netlisting errors, you'll see them pop up, but generally OrCAD X will automatically launch OrCAD X Presto for us into a empty design. The easiest way to verify that our netlist came through is just to simply look at the properties on the right hand side. Now this is a context sensitive properties panel. We're going to be using this quite a lot throughout the videos. Without going into too much detail, however, you notice it here that there is a status unplaced component section and a blue link. If I click on this blue link, this search panel at the bottom will be populated with all of these 46 unplaced components. If I scroll through here, I should see that, yep, you know, these are some of the components that are in my design. The part name or the part number matches, the footprint matches, and any other information that I might be looking for just to verify. Now, because our designs are linked, if we make any changes to schematic, we can automatically push those changes to the layout. I'm just going to go ahead and find my SD4 on here. So what we want to do just to verify is in OrCAD Capture, we're going to go to the peripherals page and this SD, we're just going to change this reference designator from SD4 to SD1 because there is only one SD part in our design. Hit OK. Once we've changed that reference designator, we can save. And then simply, again, go to the PCB menu at the top, select Update Layout. We'll get this nice little pop-up that gives us an overview of all the changes that are made. So in this case, the change type is a reference designator changed. the new value is SD1 and the old value is SD4. Now we don't actually need to close OrCAD X Presto, we can leave it open. Go ahead and select Sync. And if we jump back into OrCAD X Presto, if I scroll down, I can see that my part is now called SD1. You can do the same from the layout tool. So if I make a change in OrCAD X, let's say I change this to SD2. Save the design. And then jump back into OrCAD X Presto. If I go into ECO, Update PCB, you can see that we have the same pop-up, and it's just grabbing that change from the schematic, and then we can bring it into the layout by selecting Sync. Again, let's scroll down and verify. There's SD2. Now, the final test that we want to make is just to make sure that we can cross-probe between our schematic and our layout. To do so, I'm just quickly going to place a part from our schematic onto the design. Let's place this SD card connector. We're going to go over component placement in greater detail in a future video, but for now, we just have this one part. Now, if I select it in OrCAD X, I should also expect it to be selected in Presto. So I'm going to go ahead and click it, and I can verify that it's been highlighted and selected. So let's deselect it and go in the other direction. Make sure it's deselected here. I can click on it in Presto, do a right-click cross-probe. And inside of OrCAD X Capture, I can see that the part has been selected. And this works for components, nets, and other types of objects. So perfect. Our designs are now synced up and ready to go. In the next video, we'll talk about importing a board outline from DXF or how to draw a custom board outline. Here you can see we just have a square outline. See you then.